This video tutorial I will explain Spring Boot REST template. Here you can see the database. I am going to use MySQL, and here you can see Spring Boot demo application which will expose REST endpoint for creating the employee record, updating the employee record, getting the employee record and delete the employee record. And here you can see Spring Boot REST template demo, which is another Spring Boot application. In this Spring Boot application, using REST template, we will call Spring Boot demo application different endpoints and get the result. And I will use Postman client to send request to Spring Boot REST template demo. And the request goes to Spring Boot demo, then DB, then finally the response goes back to the Postman client. Here you can see Spring Boot application with folder structure, and here you can see pom.xml. Here I have defined a class employee service controller, which is a REST controller, and it has a create employee method which accept employee object. And to call this method, we have to send request to this path, and method is post. And it has update employee method which accept ID and the employee object. To call this method, we have to send request to this path, and method is put. And here ID is the path variable. And it has get employee method which accept ID, and to call this method, we have to send request to this path. Here ID is the path variable, and method is get. And it has get employees method. To call this method, we have to send request to this path, and method is get. And it has delete employee method, and it accept ID, and to call this method, we have to send request to this path, and method is delete. Here I have defined a class application, which is Spring Boot application. I am starting this Spring Boot application in debug mode. Here you can see Spring Boot application is started in 8080 port. Here you can see Spring Boot REST template demo, which is another Spring Boot application, and here you can see its folder structure. Here you can see pom.xml. I have included the dependency of web. Here I have defined a class employee. It has four properties: ID, name, age and salary. And getter and setter methods for these four properties. Using REST template, we can create applications that consumes RESTful web services, and we can use exchange method to consume web services for all HTTP methods. To consume a RESTful API, we have to follow these four steps. The first step is auto add the REST template object. The second step is we have to use HTTP headers to set the request headers. And the third step is we have to use HTTP entity to wrap the request object. The fourth step is we have to use exchange method of REST template object and pass URL of the API and method of the API and entity and the return type. Here I have defined a class employee service controller, which is a REST controller, and here I have auto-wired REST template, and it has a create employee method which accept employee object, and to call this method, we have to send request to this path, and method is post, and it has update employee method which accept ID and the employee object. And to call this method, we have to send request to this path. And method is put. And it has a get employee method which accept ID. And to call this method, we have to send request to this path. And ID is the path variable. And method is the get. And it has a get employees method. To call this method, we have to send request to this path. And method is get. And it has a delete employee method which accept ID. And to call this method, we have to send request to this path. And method is delete. Here I have defined the class RestTemplate application, which is a Spring Boot application. And here I have defined the bean of RestTemplate. While starting the application, RestTemplate object will be created and injected here. I am starting this Spring Boot application. The Spring Boot application is started in 9090 port. Because we have configured port as 9090. Here you can see employee table and it does not have any records. Using Postman client, I am going to send employee create request to Spring Boot RestTemplate demo application. And method is post. Body we have to choose as raw type and JSON we are going to send. And here you can see employee object in JSON format. Sending the request. And using exchange method, I am sending request to Spring Boot demo application. The request reaches Spring Boot demo application. Here you can see the output. Employee is created successfully with the primary key 12. Refresh. And here you can see employee record is created. Next I will send the update request. Method is put. And I am changing the age to 75. And salary is 60,000. Sending the request. Using exchange method, I am sending update employee request to Spring Boot demo application. Request reaches to Spring Boot demo application. Here we got the output. Employee is updated successfully. Refresh and employee record is updated. Age is 75 and salary is 60,000. Next, I will send get employee request. Method is get, sending the request. Using exchange method, I am sending get request to Spring Boot demo application. The request reaches to Spring Boot demo application. Here we got the output. We got the employee object in JSON format. Next, I will send delete request. Method is delete, sending the request. Using exchange method, I am sending a delete request to Spring Boot demo application. The request reaches to Spring Boot demo application. Here we got the output. Employee is deleted successfully. Refresh and you can see the employee record is deleted successfully. Here I have added two employee records. Next I am going to get all the employee records from the employee table and method is get, sending the request. Using exchange method of RestTemplate object, I am sending request to Spring Boot demo application to get all the employee records. Request reaches to Spring Boot demo application. Here we got the output. We got array of employee objects in JSON format. There are two records are there and we got two employee objects in JSON format. You can get Java source code link for each video in the description section of the video. Here you can see the description section. Click on show more and here you can see the Java source code links. Click on these links to get the Java source code.